Yeah, go get ready. Come on. Go get your shoes. Come on. Go put your vest on. Come on. Come on. As a matter of fact, go get all your stuff.
Come on! That's right. What you saying? Just say what? You better go get your hat. Come on! Just said yes, and here's the reason. He saw me up there all alone, so for my sin he did atone. He purchased me, I'm not my own, I wanna please him. So now I serve him, who brought me and is able to keep me up together in the presence of his glory. I found for my life his good and perfect purpose was designed to bring me to the place where he had need of me. So I wanna my destiny, yeah.
Can't settle for
nothing short of what you want me to be or want me to be, cause
I want it
to be my destiny.
Gotta be destiny.
Not called to sit upon the shelf. He did not die just for his health. And with the time we have, let's waste not all on selfish reasons. But we must seek to please him first. Find his will upon the earth. When they look back from death to birth, they'll say they've seen him. So we must serve him who brought us and is able to keep us all together in the presence of his glory. We find for our lives his good and perfect purpose was designed to bring us to the place where he needs us to be. Do you want your destiny? Come on, come on, come on.
Thank you. creation. For by him all things were created, things in heaven and on earth, visible and invisible. For the thrones and powers, the rulers or authorities, all things were created by him and for him. He is before all things. He in him all things hold together. And he is the head of the body of the church. He is the beginning, the firstborn from among the dead, so that everything he might have supremacy. For God was pleased to have all his fulfillments dwell in him, and through him to reconcile to himself all things. For the things on earth, the things in heaven, are making peace through his blood shed on the cross. Again, reading from the first chapter of Colossians, verses 15 through 20. And the Lord has a special blessing to hear his word. All right. Thank you. God, for a moment of prayer. Oh God, and our Father, who art in heaven, we come humbly this morning, dear God, just to say thank you once again, Father, for another day. Father, we come, Lord, thank God, humble, Father, in our hearts, Father. Yes. We come, dear God, thank you, Father. Father, for we know we're not worthy, dear God, calling on your name, Father, and all your blessings, and all your mercy, Father. We thank you, Lord, our God, for sparing us, Father, protecting us, Father, all week, Lord, our God.
Yes.
Leading us through the front, Father, in the various byways and highways, Lord, our God. Thank you. Thank you, Father, for protecting us, Father, Lord, our God, at work, Father. Thank you, Father, for keeping us at home, Lord, our God. That's the same thing, Father, for covering us with the blood of your Son, Jesus, as we slept last night in the very empty death. Lord, my God, we come thanking you, Father, humbly right now, dear God. Ask you, Father, for forgiveness, Father, of sin and transgression, Father, we commit it, Lord, Father. Father, we ask you, God, now, Father, that you please heal, Father, those, Father, who need healing. Father, we ask you, God, that you please protect those, Father, who need protection, Father. We ask, Father, that you please, Father, stop by here, Father, long as your spirit, Father, praise your name this morning, God. Father, if there's anybody here, Father, with an unfair heart, Father, we ask you, God, that you touch the heart, Father, fill it with the Holy Spirit right now, Father. Father, we ask you, God, that you please stop by the hospitals, Father, the various infirmities around the world, Father, around the community, Lord, Father. Touch those, Father, who need healing right now. And Father, we pray, Father, for the families of glory, Father, to you, put the dead in your families, Father. We pray for you, Father, to lift them up, Father, in prayer right now, dear God. Father, be with them right now in this trying time, Lord God. Father, we pray, Father, for all those who need prayer right now, dear God. Now, look into the church here, Father. We need you in the land right now, dear God, with various things going on, Father, earthquakes and wars, Father. We ask you, God, that you please, Father, be in those places, Father. Be there for those people right now, dear God. Be there for us right now, dear God. Father, tell someone, Father, that's standing, Father, someone that's alive right now, dear God, who don't know, Father, that you're in the fair part of their sins right now, dear God. Please touch them, Father. Give us what we need, Father, God, to find these people, Father, to touch them right now, dear God. Father, God, we thank you, Father, for all things, Father. All things, Father, that we know that we receive through you, Father, and some of the things, Father, we don't know that we receive, Father. Dear God, we thank you for all things, Father, God. When this life is over, dear God, we ask, Father, in the strong and powerful name of your Son Jesus, that you accept us in your kingdom right now, Father. Dear God, these strong blessings we ask in your Son Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Good morning, church. Thank you, choir. Thank you. Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Amen. Here we are. I was wondering if I was in here by myself. Amen. I thank the Lord for the opportunity to be among his people one more time. I count this as a privilege because God made this possible for us to come together and have this fellowship. Not nothing that I've done, but everything that he's done. Amen. We're going to go into our responsive reading this morning. In your program, we'll be looking from the book of Psalms. Amen. Psalms chapter 19, verses number 1, 7, 8, 13, and verse 14 from the New International Version. I'll read the M, you read the C, and A is for all. Amen?
Amen.
The heavens declare the glory of God, the skies proclaim the work of his hand.
The law of the Lord is perfect,
revelation of souls.
The statutes of the Lord are trustworthy, making wise the simple.
The precepts of the Lord are right, giving joy to the heart.
Keep your servants also from willful sins, may they not rule over me.
Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight, O Lord,
my strength and my redeemer. Amen. Amen. Thank you. Brief word. We're going to be taking some photos on today. This is our Black history, and I want to incorporate those into our this coming Sunday service on our channel. Amen. So that people can see, look where the Lord has brought us from. I think they call this Sunday best.
Amen.
Sunday best. Amen. I had to dress down because my wife, amen, she was standing too far out there. I wasn't going to compete with her. Amen. She's out there. First lady. Stand up, first lady. I just got to ask her. I had to look quiet this morning. Amen. Stand up, let her see you. Amen. I ain't going to compete with that this morning. She got the boost with the booster match. I said, thank God. Amen. Sunday best. That old song said, look where he brought us from. From the coveralls. Amen. So Stacey Adams and whatever the women be wearing. Amen. Listen, we're going to turn you over to the hands of the choir, Shiloh Community Church Choir this time.
Thank you. kept us. That's what I love about it. What a mighty God. What I want to share with you, a few days ago, my little brother, Death. I don't know when we'll have services, that's all in limbo, but as soon as I know something in our religion, know that. He spent all of his life, from approximately 18 to 19 years of age, driving those 18 wheelers all over America and all into Canada. So he wasn't around a whole lot. But one thing I know, every Christmas that this church has been in this place, he've always bought all of the fruits, all of the pecans, the walnuts, and whatever, and wanted no pay for it. He loved doing that. And he loved his church as well as his family. So just pray for our family. Thank you very much. All right.
Amen. Surely our condolences go out to Pastor Devenport and Devenport's family. Amen. Such sad news. But listen, we're going to go ahead on into our offertorial part of the service. Amen. We are now going to turn you over to the hands of the ushers. Amen. And our deacons.
Subscribe to come to.
Lord, thank you for your giving.
Right.
May the Lord bless us. Listen, we're going to have a moment in Black history at this time, and we're going to have our own Reverend Moore come and share with us.
Right.
Moment in Black history. Let us give him a hand clap of applause.
Amen. A moment in Black history. Today we'll be talking about James Weldon Johnson, who was born in Florida in 1871. He was the national organizer of the NAACP and the author of poetry and nonfiction, and perhaps best known for the song, Lift Every Voice and Sing.
All right.
The Creation by James Weldon Johnson. God stepped out onto space, and he looked around and said, I'm lonely. I'll make me a world. And as far as the eye of God could see, darkness covered everything. Yeah. Blacker than 100 midnights down in a cypress swamp. Yeah. Then God smiled and the light broke. And the darkness rolled up on one side and the light stood shining on the other. And God said, that's good.
All right.
Then God reached out and took the light in his hands and God rolled the light around in his hands until he made the sun. And he set the sun ablazing in the heavens. And the light that was left from making the sun, God gathered it up in a shining ball and threw it into the darkness and spangling the night with the moon and the stars. Then down between the darkness and the light, he hurled the world and God said, that's good.
Yeah. Yeah.
Then God himself stepped down. And the sun was on his right hand, and the moon was on his left. And the stars were clustered around his head. And the earth was under his feet. And God walked, and where he trod, his footsteps hollowed the valleys out and bulged out the mountaintops. Then he stopped, and he looked and saw that the earth was hot and barren. So God stepped over to the edge of the world, and he spat out seven seas. He batted out his eyes, and the lightning flashed. He clapped his hands, and the thunders rolled. And the waters above the earth came down. The cooling waters came down.
Yes. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And then the green grass sprouted, and the little red flowers blossomed. The pine tree pointed to the finger in his sky, and the oak spread out his arms, and the lakes tumbled down to the hollows of the ground, and the river ran down to the sea, and God smiled again, and the rainbow appeared and curled itself around his shoulder. Then God raised his arm and he waved his hand. And over the sea and over the land, he said, bring forth, bring forth. And quicker than God could drop his hand, fish and fowl and beasts and birds, and swam the rivers and the seas, and roamed the forest and the woods, and split the air with their wings. And God said, that's good. Then God walked around and God looked around, and all they had made, he looked at his sun, he looked at his moon, he looked at his little stars, he looked at his world with all its living things, and God said, I'm lonely still. Then God sat down on the side of a hill where he could think by a deep, wide river. He sat with his head in his hands. God thought and thought till he said, I'll make me a man. And up from the bed of the river, God scooped up the clay, and by the bank of the river, he kneeled him down, and there the great God Almighty, who lit up the sun and fixed it in the sky, who flung the stars to the most farthest corners of the night, who rounded the earth in the middle of his hand, this great God, like a mammy bending over her baby, kneeling down in the dust, toiling over the lump of clay, till he shaped it to his own image. Then he blew into it the breath of life, and man became a living soul. Amen. Amen.
I must say that's the word. Amen. That's the word. Amen. You got the NIV, you got the Living Word, you got the King James Version. Amen. Now you got the Reverend Moore version. Well done. Excellent. Excellent. Praise the Lord. Amen. Listen, I want to say this also, that these services are now posted on our channel, the YouTube channel. And you can see them every Sunday. You can go back and look at the previous services as well as all the updated services. And this Black History Month services will be on there. And we want you to look at that, like it, and subscribe. Amen. And we'll post more on there. And also, if you need to know the YouTube name or the title, just ask me. It's simple. I actually took a photo of it, so I don't have to eat all those acronyms. Amen. So at this time, we're going to go on into our song service. Amen. Amen. And bring you up again, the Shiloh Community Choir. Amen.
Thank you.
if you can have a friend, you answer what you're praying. I've heard some good musicians. I only know of one other organist that was not a church organist. Her name was Bless. She played with my neighbor. He had a jazz band, J.T.R. Hayes. They didn't need a bass because Lex mastered the bass and the keyboard part. God gives each of us a gift to be used for His glory and honor. To worship Him, to praise Him, but to worship Him. God loves worshipers. When you can get out of self, then God can use you. But long as self wants to control. So I thank God for this great organist that we have here. I want to revisit a message that I did, I think, in 2016. I sort of put it on my heart to do that because it is so resonant with today. I want to thank you, Reverend Moore, for doing Jane Wilder Truth so excellent. Where was Eve when God created Adam? Anybody have an idea? Where was Eve? Eve when God created Adam. She was already in prison. He put him asleep and formed him a mate and put him side by side. I'm trying to say something to the men. He didn't put her by side to be abused by him. Some of these fellas, their wife can't go around the corner with them without having an attitude. I can't use another word, control freaks. And can't control themselves.
Right. All right, Rick.
She is a helpmate, and any man that got a good wife, and you a fool who crossed the street. Grass ain't no green. On the other side is on where you hang out.
All right, Rick.
From the Gospel of John, I believe. St. John, chapter 14, verse 27. it getting warm in here? Maybe we ought to have just a little taste of air. Verse 27, peace I leave with you, my peace I give you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your heart be troubled, and do not be afraid. Stay in that same book, chapter 16. Verse 33. We have it. Amen. Chapter 16, St. John. I have told you these things, so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart, I have overcome the world. Our message is from minus to a plus. Two minus four leaves what?
Two.
Said, God is getting our attention. As for all of the problems that we're going through in these difficult days that's ahead. But in light of what's going on around us and throughout this nation that we call America, there is no peace. There was a time in my day that people could leave their homes and leave the doors unlocked. And when they got back, everything was in place. Our world is getting worse and worse. In every moment, every evening, we watch the local news. Millions of people in the United States sit down and watch some of the nastiest material ever seen on television. Back in the day when you could only have a little small screen in black and white, sometimes it played clear and sometimes it didn't. You didn't get all of what we get today on our television. They tell you how to play your wife or your husband. But God loves us. So don't worry about what's happening. Know that God is in control. Nothing that has happened, nothing that will happen, is not unknown to God. Because when God created the heavens and the earth, as the poem was stated, after all of his creation, he looked back and he said, that's good. But once we allow the enemy to invade our space, things change. He don't have no new tricks. It's same old, same old. And we keep forwarding, forward. Because when we look at our news, the news has horror show and an added twist. Tragically, all these stories are true. Everything you see is true. As it relates to what's happening in our world. Think of some of the items over the last few years. We can recall even the attempt that we had with COVID-19 was devastating. But if you understand, in 2013, there were approximately 30,000 people that died. See, you don't know when a storm is going to hit you. You don't even know whether an earthquake would hit this area we call Houston, Texas. But in Syria and Turkey, it's already right at 50,000 deaths. And they're still trying to locate. But God is a miraculous God. Even the days that have passed, occasionally, they find one alive. Even little babies born during that tragedy surviving. You wonder why did God choose those few and let thousands die? It's not that God hates the world, but he hates sin, but he loves the sinner. Can you imagine all 50,000? Then he said there will be wars and rumors of war. And I really don't hope nothing tragic happens to a demagogue named Putin. Invade someone's space and try to take them all out. But if you know, it's coming up again. Whatever you sow, you're going to reap, because the word of God says it emphatically. I did this in 2016. Even the bomb planted outside of businesses and drive-by shooting and road rage is getting out of order. And we saying, God, where are you? And God is saying to us, I'm still where you can contact me. If my people that are called by my name and humble themselves and turn from their wicked ways, then and only then will I step in and bring peace to the world. The devil has churches. Let me say that again. Satan has churches. And it's designed to take away what God has ordained. Because he's a copycat. He's a wannabe. And there are all kinds of religions now. But it's not of God. And we just fall for anything.
Come on, break.
We think it's right. You're either a Christian or you're lost. All you have to do is call on the name of the Lord and say, Lord, I will obey your word. Then you're saved.
Amen.
He said, I've come to seek and to save. You will only have peace. You can have a congregation of 15. They're going to have different opinions. You can be a member of a major church. There's no church on earth that's perfect as long as you and I are there. And we let the enemy fool us. God created a race of people. See, this to me is just stupid. What race are you?
Human race.
When you go anywhere and fill out papers, what race are you? Once we understand that either you are a Jew or you are a Gentile, you can name it and claim it, you're still what you are. Because your religion don't save you. It's a relationship with God. Some of us, we don't know whether we're going to wake up the next day or not. Not only is road rage a danger to humanity, you can't even lay down in your bed, but remember God has your back. What's going to happen, God has already seen. And God has a plan of escape.
Yes.
What, Pastor, why do Christians die? When you get to heaven, ask God. Because we don't have an answer. Why God saved some and let others go to hell? No, God don't let you go. You go voluntarily because you don't want to obey rules. See, you can't go into another man or woman's space and try to control. That's not your area. You better off stand where you are. Bombs are exploding, and we don't know how long before something tragic happened to Houston. But one thing I know. God is my keeper. He is my protector. And if by some strange catastrophic event and I die, yet I'm alive. So it's best to have a relationship with God. We're living now. When we were in school, we didn't have to worry about a student coming to school with no weapon. Now the six-year-old upset with the instructor and shoots her. That wasn't good enough. Now another one takes his BB gun to school and shoots up the whole handful. So we're living in a day that we're questioning, what is God going to do about it? God has already done something for us. People would rather rob, steal, and kill to get what they want because they're too lazy to work. I hope this ain't offending nobody. There are people on welfare, healthier than I am, that need a job, but they play the system. You gotta be careful who you align yourself with. Jesus said, I am the Prince of Peace.
Yes, sir.
The peace I give you, the world can't take. I made this analogy. You can take two of the meanest bulldogs. What's the other ones they call them? They're always fighting. Them pit bulls. And put them both in the same area. But on this one, you got a restraint. On that one, you got a restraint. And the only reason they ain't fighting because they can't get to.
Yeah.
And therefore, you need someone in your space, and that's Jesus.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
God still works miracles. I was listening to a story, wasn't a story, it was a religious program, where this lady was a member of this church. And this man was shooting people at the church. And when he put the gun to her, it went off. It went off again. It stood. It went off again. It stood. And he fell down on his knees because the lady standing before him knew God. He said it wasn't her time. But he fell down, and she was telling this story, her personal story. She said, today, that man is my pastor, but also my husband. If you think God ain't awesome, God can move mountains with just thinking about it. Now, since I know that he can change my minuses into a plus, now we have another problem. And God, I hope I get this.
Come on, Brady.
Eggs are going up.
Come on, Brady.
Food's going up. Have y'all noticed? I love Fig Newton with some half and half milk. I saw a little bitty box, much smaller than what I was accustomed to buying. But it cost me $4 and something. But God is saying to us, don't be fearful. If I can take two fish and five little loaves of bread and feed 5,000, am I not still God? I can feed you out of nothing, and you don't have a clue where it comes from. These are the times in which we live. And why should we believe in God
if he seemed to do nothing about all of these tragedies that are going on. The truth is that God has done something about the evil and suffering in our world. He's already did something.
Right.
Over 2,000 years ago, he sent his son, one of the world's worst trouble spots. God knows Earth got a serious problem. We have a hate relationship. We have a get even mentality. But if I'm a child of God, I get on my knees and I talk to God about it. Because he said, I, God, will fight your battle. But it ain't going to happen until you call on him seriously. Truthfulness. God said, I'll fight you now. In fact, while you're praying, while you're praying, I've already fixed the problem. You have to stand on it. You know what I love about God? He didn't have to say nothing to us. But he had it in black and white through one of the prophetic preachers. I see it. I know it. I knew this day was going to come. Well, God, when did you take care of it? I taken care of the problem before you were born.
Thank you.
Now that just goes y'all head, I know. There is nothing new under. We think something is new.
Right.
I just bought a new car, a new truck, a new motorcycle, a new home. Yes, you did, but it was already here. It was already here. The reason you got a house is God planted some trees in the beginning. You got material to build cars because God put the iron already here before you got here. And yet we don't realize what an awesome God we serve. Jesus grew up in a roughneck town. Born in a manger. Some of y'all born in a five-star hotel, not hotel, a five-star hospital, brother.
All right.
Some of us had to go to dental office. If you ain't got no money, you can get waited on. But do you know when you got the money, you can get the vents, care? But even if you can't, I know somebody. It's a mighty good healer. He can heal you that it won't ever come back to you. But we have to keep on trusting, keep on praying. Why did God give you a mouth to speak? If you're bold enough and you can speak to your own problem, it may not happen right after you get off your knees, but keep on praying.
Amen.
And you know, we live in the time now. Thank you, Jesus. Now, some folks say, where's your faith? You done prayed once. Your faith can do it. But if you know the word,
come on, pray.
Jesus went to his own Father three times.
Yes. Amen. Come on now. Come on.
So Jesus had to pray to the Father. You think you're going to get it done in just one prayer? Half sleep when you pray? Jesus was surrounded by violence, poverty, and diseases. And diseases are getting more prevalent because we don't eat right. Amen, nice and warm.
Right.
Stop.
There are certain foods.
Come on, break.
Why did God plant a garden? You know the cattle and all of that, but everything that's edible has to come from the ground.
Yeah.
Y'all can go buy all this synthetic stuff too. But you know, back in the day we had to do your own garden.
Yeah.
There were no pesticides you had to use. You just trust God for the rain and the wind. Pray the seed, go on about your business. God put everything here to keep us what? Healthy. God loves us. Jesus spent his life bringing love of God to ordinary people. He healed the sick. He taught people to love those who hated them. We don't do that today. We tell our kids better take something with you when you go to school. You don't know what you may run into. See, God can take your minuses and make them a plus.
Amen.
Y'all remember, I've said this a lot of times, it needs to be repeated, that this woman that had a relationship with God, she knew God, but her cupboard was bad, and she was praying seriously to God her needs. She didn't have anything. But God had two little boys to be right there when she was praying. She didn't know they was outside listening. So they made a decision. We're going to buy her some groceries, bring them back, put them on the front porch, and then knock on the door. Then we go inside of the house and hide. And when she came up, she began to rejoice. Because God had heard her prayer, and they stood right back and said, God didn't do that. We heard you praying, we went and did that. She said, well, God just used two little devils to feed me. See, we need to understand how powerful God is. There is nothing that God cannot do. Are you on the Lord's side?
Yes.
Or are you on somebody else's side?
Amen.
But also when you do these great things as Jesus did, but Jesus also made some powerful enemies. In the end, the politicians fixed it for him. So we had crooked politicians back in that day. They worse today. They're a bunch of liars and crooks.
Yep.
They ain't. It's about my party. It's not about you and you. If you want to do something for the nation, work it together. But everybody's power hungry. Who wants you to be powerful? Satan. Get your gun. People don't think nowadays. They figure guns serve. That gun solves problems. Where there is a problem, there's always a solution, and God is the solution. Y'all agree with that? You're going to make enemies when you do good. Everybody here got some haters. I don't care how nice you want to be and try to be, somebody's hating on you. But let them hate on to hell. I'm going to do what God has called. a kid in town, Israel. He was supposed to be there. Lord put it there. See, now the only difference, I say this again, if you are not a Jew by birth, I don't care what you call yourself, you still what you were born. Do you understand how awesome God is? There are many, many people in Israel. They are Jews, but to this day, to this day, they have not accepted Jesus as their Lord and Savior. Jesus said, if you love like I tell you to do, then you kept all of my commandments. Yeah. So all you got to do is love for them.
Yeah.
Live right. That's all he requires. We go jumping all these outside makeup, church believers, whatever you want to call them. And the devil, he's so close that he know a lot.
Yep.
And he's still fooling us.
Yeah.
Yeah. I gotta say this.
Come on, pray.
If you ever walk down the ground of Little York area in West Montgomery, this little fella dressed up in his little suit, working for Mohammed, Muslim, y'all seen him?
Yeah.
You know where you find him now? Right by CVS, in that raw green era, looking ragged as don't know what. Sister Jerry and I said, boy, I need to get in church with him. Once he stopped me and asked for him a hand, I'm going to say, what happened to Mohammed, bro? You telling me how good he is. Now here you are in your bed, ragged, and you ain't got no suit on. The devil will fool you.
Yes, he will.
And you go off and you get in something. Oh, if you need your roots of Christianity, I don't care how good it might sound.
Yeah.
Jesus ain't in it. Child of God, I suffer Jesus as my Lord and Savior, and no other gonna come and tell me that's not the way. But I heard Jesus say, I am the way, the truth, and the life, and no man was running behind him anything. Storefront something. Now we go. God ain't in there. They have us doing something opposite of what we ought to be doing. God is an awesome God. And I ain't even got close to the closing of this. Help me, Lord Jesus.
Come on, Frank.
Some people say that the Christian faith is out of touch with reality. But the life and death of Jesus show that simply cannot be true. A real Jesus was pinned and nailed to a cross.
Yeah.
Man.
Yeah.
A real Jesus was hung on a piece of wood and shed real blood. The cross was terrifying. Bloody execution. It was as down to earth as you can get. Have you ever got a big splinter in your finger? That's painful. You ever got your finger Slam when you slam the door, your friend in that car. That's pain. But can you imagine spikes in your hand hanging on a pole, feet nailed to the wood, nothing sustain your weight? That's agony. But he did it. He did it. He did it for me. He did it for you. He died. He didn't have to die. He said, I came here to die. Something wrong in the human race. There is a solution. When God sent his son, the crucifixion of Jesus in AD 30 is not small local event of long ago. Jesus' death released the power of God. Say that again. Released the power of God's love that he could see you sinning and yet love you. Into the world, and it has changed our lives today. Back in the early 19th century, we came to the conclusion that we've arrived. We signed all of these peace accords with the other nations, but yet we are in a serious trouble with your family. Mac, I've always thought like this. If all of that in New York, where they hang out at, the World Council, if all of those men that signed that, listen to what I'm saying, they were over nations. If they would sign that, all of them, and step in Putin's office and say, you're wrong. Stop it now, or all of us will annihilate you.
Amen.
That's all. But you can't get folks to agree. We want to hold.
That's right. I mean, that's right.
We want to hold on to the devil's hand and walk with you. I know I need Jesus, but I want to hold on. But it ain't gonna happen. God said, if I'm not first, I'm not at all. Help me, Lord Jesus. Christianity does not turn a blind eye to human suffering. Like the bulletin we see on the news, Jesus' crucifixion in that day and time, when they'd have had television, he'd make extra come across the TV screen. We just crucified the so-called Savior. He would have made national news. But he's a good God. Let me skip some here, because so much that we need to know about Jesus. Instead, the problem is actually closer to home. Well, Pastor, what is the problem? The problem is actually in our heart. Every evil thought that come across your mind was put there my enemy.
Yeah.
We have a heart problem.
Yeah.
And I'm not talking about when you love somebody.
Yeah.
The problem is when our own soul, in our own mind. Yeah, the problem is a hard problem.
Yeah.
And it is a sin. Jesus can punish this when he said, from the inside, from the person heart, come the evil ideas. The devil is always putting ideas in your mind. Am I on your street right now? I don't care how strong you are in your faith. I don't care how often you are in church on Sunday. The enemy of God is always planting ideas in your mind. And we listen to him because what he says pleases my flesh. Is that right? He gives you the ideas how to get over on your friends. He gives you the ideas how to get your neighbor's wife a husband. The mark. Let me drop down. You know how you miss the mark. Yes. How many of y'all got some guns? I'm not saying this coming something out. But you may have a target, and your desire is to hit that target in the middle. But you miss it to the left or right. We intend to do what God tells us to do, but we miss it along the way. Your intentions were right. All right. I know it's all right. your disease. How am I? How does sin work in our world toward the end of the 19th century? We thought we had arrived. We could cure whatever we wanted to cure. We could grow whatever we wanted to grow. But it all fell apart. If Jesus is not in the plan, it ain't gonna happen. Yes, Lord, violence on our streets, child abuse in our homes, hatred between people of different nationalities. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
All right, all right.
Hallelujah.
I want to finish this.
All right, go
ahead. But I got to bring it down.
All right, bring it.
When COVID-19 hit, and husbands and wives went home together. But as long as one was working, the other one was, there wasn't no problems. But when COVID put them all in the same house, husband and wife got to the place they couldn't stand each other. Seemed like me, love should have got better than that, but it got worse and worse. Are y'all listening? The devil is moving.
God.
Why you were so in love? Why now you both at home? But you can't stand the other one being in the house. Where did love go? If you got to go through that change, you didn't love at all, no way. God is good. Corruption. Marriage or wounded. Let me try to get this last page. What Jesus did. God is with us. On the third day, Jesus, the carpenter of Nazareth, turned the wood of the cross into a door of life. Minuses turned to plus and negative to positive. On the cross where Jesus hung and while he was hanging there, he said, Father, forgive them, for they don't really know what they are doing. They don't know who they're crucifying. Yes, can you picture in your mind on Calvary? They should have said when Pilate said, I don't find no fault. I know it's good that I got to release one of the two. Barabbas was a thug and a criminal, but Jesus was the life giver. Jesus was the heart fixer. Jesus was the bread that fed 5,000. So many wonderful things. Oh Lord, yes, but the enemy in that crowd seem like at this time we want all of the criminals to be good. But there is none good but God. Let's see what he did on the cross. He turned darkness into light. A little bit higher.
Father, most gracious and eternal God, Father, it's just us again. Coming the humblest way that we know. Our heads bow towards the dust from which we have come. But our hearts are lifted towards heaven's throne. We come, Father, as we have come so many times before. As children before an able parent. Standing, Lord, with tiptoe anticipation. Expecting a blessing right now. Father God, we come today first to say thank you for your word. Father God, we thank you today for the preacher, the messenger of this day, O God.